TC Kidz, my name is Pastor Warren, and I am so excited to be hanging out with you today. Now, we're in a series called Custom Creations. There's only one you, and this whole month, we're going to be talking about, yeah, you guessed it, individuality. This means that you are discovering who you're meant to be so you can make a difference. For today's experience, you got to have these three things, so I want you to go grab them real quick. You need a Bible. Yep. You need a pen and some paper. Now, as always, we've got a hidden object that you've got to keep your eyes open for. Today's hidden picture, it's a GIF. So sometime during the experience, this GIF will pop up, but it's only going to pop up once. So see if you can spot it. And at the end of today's experience, we'll ask you where you found the GIF. TC Kidz, let's get going.
Hey, what's up, TC Kidz? I have my hype squad with me, and it's time to worship.
Where could I go? Where could I go? Without you beside me. Where could I run? Where could I run? 'Cause your love always
Okay, roll! Okay, we're gonna go to the right.
You never change, you stay the same, and your heart's always full.
Roll!
Over and over, you're with me wherever.
Let's go, guys.
Oh, oh. Over and over, you're with
yes,
me.
Yes, good job.
I go. Oh, oh.
Up!
There's no boundary line.
Jump, jump, jump. Yes, guys. Okay, forward.
Nothing left to hide. I'm love 'cause you love.
guys, do you want to play a game? Awesome, let's do it. This game is called Name That Candy Bar. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna look at a candy bar without its wrapper. And we're gonna see if we're able to name all the candies. Are you guys ready to take a look at our first candy? Let's do it. Okay, what do we think this one is? It looks like it has chocolate, maybe some coconut in it. What, maybe an Almond Joy? I don't know, guys. What do you guys think it is? Okay, are we ready to find out? You're right, it was a Mounds bar. Did you get that one? I didn't get that one right. But are you ready to try again? Let's look at our next candy bar. Ooh, I don't know, guys. I feel like I can read this one, maybe. Do you guys recognize this candy bar? It looks like a Kit Kat to me. Should we see what it is? We were right! Great job, guys. Did you guess Kit Kat? Nice. Okay, let's look at our third candy bar. Ooh, this one looks hard. Looks like it's got caramel, some chocolate, maybe some crunchy in the middle. Oh, I don't know, maybe a Snickers? What do you guys think? A Take Five! I haven't seen one of those in so long. Have you guys ever seen one of those? Okay, guys, we have one more candy bar. Let's take a look at what it is. Oh, this one's one of my favorites. Chocolate and peanut butter. I think this one is a Reese's Peanut Butter Cup. What do you guys think? Yes, it's a Reese's Peanut Butter Cup. Great job, guys. You guys did so great guessing these candy bars. If you didn't get them all, that's okay. We can always try again. If you didn't get them all right, that's okay. But why don't you challenge a friend and see how many they can get right? We love you and we can't wait to see you guys next time. Bye, guys.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Put on your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. You got your armor, guy. Got my belt of truth, check. Breastplate of righteousness. Shoes of peace. Shield of faith. Helmet of salvation. Sword of the spirit. Helmet of salvation. Sword of the spirit. You got your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. You got your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. You got your armor, guy. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Put on your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. You got your armor, guy. Got my belt of truth, check. Breastplate of righteousness. Shoes of peace. Shield of faith. Helmet of salvation. Sword of the spirit. Helmet of salvation. Sword of the spirit. Put on your armor, guy. You got your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. You got your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. You got your armor, guy. Be strong in the Lord and his mighty power. The strength takes care of you when life's sour. Put on the armor of God and fight the enemy. Can you tell me now all the pieces you need? Be strong in the Lord and his mighty power. The strength takes care of you when life's sour. Shoes of peace, shield of faith, helmet of salvation, sword of the spirit, helmet of salvation, sword of the spirit.
Put on your armor, guy. You got your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. You got your armor, guy. Put on your armor, guy. You got 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 your armor, guy. armor done. You got your armor done. Boy, your armor done. You got your armor done.
Are you ready?
All month long, we are memorizing Psalms 139:14.
It says, "How you made me is amazing and wonderful. I praise you for that. What you have done is wonderful. I know that very well."
We've even added some actions to it. You ready?
Psalms 139:14. How you made me is amazing and wonderful. I praise you for that. What you have done is wonderful. I know that very well.
My cousin was a kid when the doctors told her she was really, really sick. They'd run all these different types of tests on her, and she was so sick, and it was really serious, that the doctors actually told her that she could die. I remember feeling like super sad and afraid for my cousin. It's one of my favorite cousins. After hearing what the doctor said, it was crazy to think that she would ever get better. But our whole family made a choice. We decided to choose faith over fear. We prayed, even though it seemed impossible, even though it looked crazy. We prayed that God would do something amazing in her body. She did everything the doctors told her to do, and our family would constantly say that she's getting better. And she did. God slowly began to heal her body. And today, my cousin is all grown up and is a professor at a major university in the United States. She had crazy faith. Faith to believe the impossible. Faith to talk about being well long before she could see or experience what she needed God to do in her body. What about you? Do you have crazy faith? What are you believing God for right now that seems impossible? That some would even say it's crazy. Maybe you have a family member that's sick and your family's believing God right now that they'll get better. Well, he can do it, and we want to agree with you. So I'm gonna ask you to do something. I'm gonna ask you to get your family to help you send us a short video and let us know what you have crazy faith for. We wanna agree with you today.
Hi TC, we've got crazy faith. I have crazy faith because one day I will explore the world as a photographer. Tice, what do you have crazy faith for?
For these. One day I will be a police officer and help people.
Bye TC.
Bye TC.
I have crazy faith for my sister to be a healthy baby.
Today's Bible story is found in Matthew. Now, Matthew is found in the New Testament and is one of the four Gospels. Do you know what those four books are? You're right. They're Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And today's story starts in the first book, Matthew. Are you ready to unbox some more of God's Word? Perfect. Let's do it.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story. Inspired by the book of Matthew, chapter 9, verses 9 through 13.
Everyone in the shore town of Capernaum knew who Matthew was.
You may also call me Levi.
But few people actually liked him.
Well, that's rude.
Truth is, Matthew had put himself in an awkward situation. He was Jewish, like his relatives and friends, but he chose to work for the hated Roman government.
Just trying to make a living.
Matthew was a tax collector for the Romans, and tax collectors were known to lie about the amount of money people owed.
5 gold pieces.
But it was only 3 last year.
5, and not a shekel less.
After collecting money, the tax collectors would keep the extra for themselves. Many of them grew rich by robbing the poorest people in their towns. In fact, tax collectors and sinners were considered to be the same thing.
Hey, I work hard.
But no matter how hard Matthew tried to polish his own image, deep down, he knew how others saw him. He heard their whispers as he crossed to the other side of the street to pass his booth.
I do not know how that man sleeps at night.
He's the worst, doing the Romans' dirty work.
But one day, the crowds of Capernaum were full of different news.
Did you hear about Jesus of Nazareth?
The rabbi?
He's not only a teacher. This morning, he made a lame man walk.
That's just talk.
My son was there. He saw it with his own eyes.
The whole city was ablaze with the story. And even Matthew, who was tucked away in his tax collector's booth, was fascinated.
Maybe the man just had a limp or something?
Oh, no. This Jesus has real power. He cares about people.
Well, maybe. Anyhow, you owe 3 gold pieces.
3? How are we supposed to eat for the rest of the season?
Take it up with the governor. I'm just doing my job.
I bet Jesus would have something to say to you.
Next!
Within a short time, the market became even more crowded.
Jesus! Jesus is coming this way!
From his booth, Matthew craned to see. Though he was curious, deep down, he had to admit that no rabbi would have kind words for him.
I'm a fool. Even my own people hate me.
Suddenly, the crowds parted. Just down the street, Matthew could see a tall man with a rugged face and piercing eyes. A group of common fishermen followed at his heels.
It's Jesus.
Matthew watched, waiting for the rabbi to pass him by. Instead, Jesus stopped right in front of Matthew's booth.
Rabbi?
Jesus looked directly at Matthew, reading every single thought in his heart.
Nice day? Not too hot. Not too cold.
Jesus kept his gaze fixed directly on Matthew's face.
Come, follow me.
Shocked, Matthew looked around. The crowd has fallen away.
Who? Me?
Jesus nodded. Matthew gaped. He had no doubt in his mind that Jesus knew every single thing about him, even everything he'd done wrong. But still, Jesus wanted Matthew to join him.
Oh, well, yes.
Matthew found himself leaping up from his seat and rushing out of his booth to join Jesus on the street.
It's, nearly dinner time. Would you like to eat at my house?
To Matthew's amazement, Jesus and his followers turned their steps towards Matthew's home. Quickly, Matthew sent out word to everyone he knew.
Come to my house for dinner.
Matthew, who had expected to eat alone, found himself hosting the most famous rabbi in town for dinner, along with a ragtag group of fishermen, tax collectors, and other outcasts.
Jesus doesn't care what I've done. He thinks I can be better, that I'm worthy to follow him.
But while Matthew rejoiced to discover his brand new identity, the city's religious leaders were horrified by what Jesus had done. They sidled up to Jesus' disciples.
Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?
You know, that's a great question.
Jesus overheard the religious leaders and answered the question himself.
Those who are healthy don't need a doctor. Sick people do. I have not come to get those who think they are right with God to follow me. I have come to get sinners to follow me.
Preposterous.
From then on, Matthew followed Jesus everywhere. With his own eyes, he had seen more of the things that Jesus had done than nearly anyone else. Near the end of his life, he wrote down all the stories he had witnessed and gathered so that others too could know Jesus.
Have you ever made Jesus the Lord of your life? Romans chapter 3, verse 23, it says this, "For we've all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God." Now basically, what that means is we've all made mistakes and we need Jesus in our lives. Now right now, I want to give you an opportunity to make Jesus the Lord of your life. So I'm going to ask you if you would, bow your heads, close your eyes, and repeat this after me. Dear God, I know I've sinned and messed up. Thank you for sending your son Jesus to die on the cross for my sins. I ask you to forgive me and make me clean. I accept your love and grace for me and ask that you would be my Lord. Help me to put my trust in you and love you every day. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, I'm going to tell you something. We are so proud of you. Thank you so much for making that decision. And we've got a few next steps for you. So, number one, tell someone that you prayed this prayer. I don't care who it is. Tell somebody that you just prayed the prayer to ask Jesus into your heart. Number two, with an adult's help, I want you to click the link below this video to let us know that you just prayed the prayer. And then finally, number three, keep hanging out with us. We sure love you, and we're sure proud of you. Hey, so before we go, was this your first time hanging out with TC Kidz? Oh, wow, that's cool. So that means you are a VIP, and this is what we need you to do. We need you to click the link below that says, "I'm new to TC Kidz." And if you made the decision to follow Jesus and to put him first in your life, we want to celebrate with you. So click the "I Choose Jesus" link below and let us know. I want to tell you, remember this. You are valued. You are loved. You are unique, and you can make a difference right now.